This sensor works using a diffused light laser, so it bounces light off of the product and then uses that to either build a 2D profile or a 3D surface view of an object. And these have a guaranteed accuracy of 20 microns, like I said.
This video is brought to you by Mitutoyo. Precision is our profession. If you're looking for real-world insights, tips from leading industry experts, the latest trends in products and technology, you've come to the right place. From MSC Industrial Supply, this is Tooling Up.
Hello and welcome to Tooling Up. I'm your host, Toni Neary, and I'm so glad that you've joined us here today. Before we get started, go ahead and click those like and subscribe buttons so you never miss a single episode of Tooling Up. All right, everybody subscribed? Great. Let's dive in. Today, I'm excited. We're going to be talking about surface measurement sensors, and we have Mike Browner, the product manager for sensors and scales at Mitutoyo. Mike, thanks for joining us and welcome to Tooling Up.
Hi, thank you for having me.
So before we get into surface measurement, let's dig beneath the surface. Sorry, pun intended. Tell us a little bit about how you ended up at Mitutoyo.
Well, I've been linear motion in mechatronics and factory automation for about 18 years now. I started here about a year ago. I actually switched over to flame and vapor control and got bored because I couldn't blow anything up. And I noticed a position at Mitutoyo, and I've used their tools my whole career, and I thought it was a great opportunity to come see what I could do with my skills here.
I love that. And I love the fact that you can blow things up. So you found a job that was a little bit more stable. So when we talk about specializing in factory automation and using Mitutoyo, obviously one of the top brands in the industry, tell me a little bit about what makes Mitutoyo so special for you.
We have a great motto: good people, good technique, good products. And I've always found that to be really interesting. We're truly dedicated to making the most precise products we can. We want our products to be quality and want our products to be reliable. So we've always spent that extra time making sure that we provide the best measurement solutions and always improve our performance and accuracies.
And I didn't know that there was a more precise than precise precision, but would you say the new surface measure sensor is ultra precise?
Absolutely. The accuracy on the model I just released is 20 microns. It's the best I've found in its class. I'm in the process of actually releasing a 9 micron accuracy model, which will be the second model on the line.
So tell me a little bit about the non-contact inline sensor, because I think it's different in how the technology actually approaches surface measurement.
Absolutely. This sensor works using a diffused light laser, so it bounces light off of the product and then uses that to either build a 2D profile or a 3D surface view of an object. And these have a guaranteed accuracy of 20 microns, like I said.
So when you talk about the inline sensor, you're not talking about rollerblades, right? Why is inline so important?
Absolutely. Inline is important because it really helps to improve efficiency. While it's inline, it's being inspected as it's moving. It gives people the ability to make corrections on the fly versus now, which is done more offline or nearline. So people are taking parts off the assembly line and inspecting them. While they're inspecting them, things are still being made. So really, there could be something wrong that they're just finding out. And while they're finding it out, bad parts are being made. That ends up leading to a lot of scrap and a lot of inefficiencies.
Well, and I know we talked about it. One of the problems with that is you could get an entire pallet that you're ending up scrapping. Whereas when you're actually using the sensor and it's just part of your production line, it's running a little bit more smoothly, right?
Absolutely. That some production lines are extremely high speed. They can make up to a whole pallet of parts while they're inspecting. They find a few bad ones and they have to make the decision whether they want to inspect that whole pallet or scrap it. And most of the time ends up leading to scrapping it because it's just more cost effective that way.
So, Mike, I think one of the top topics that we're hearing right now in the industry is all about automation. And I don't think people are considering automation when it comes to inspection and looking at parts as they're moving through a production line. So can you tell me, is there an easy way to implement automation in a production line for companies and organizations out there that are looking to streamline the process?
You can really design a machine to do any job you want or look for space in an existing cell to integrate sensors. Some people have staffs to do that on, but at the other time, a lot of people are going to integrators. They're fantastic groups of people. They can design a machine, implement a sensor, commission it, and get everything running for you so that you're able to get running as quickly as possible.
And I think one of the coolest things about this technology is really the data, because it's not just about inspecting the component that's coming through, but tell me a little bit about the data you're collecting and how shops can actually use that to become more efficient.
Oh, absolutely. So if you collect all your data using an SPC system, you're able to look at how many defects you have, when the defects are, what kind of defects you have, and all kinds of various aspects of the manufacturing system, and start making high-level decisions as to what kind of changes you need to make or what kind of adjustments you need to make.
And I think it's really important that we're looking at, you know, reducing scrap. And what are your customers telling you about implementing these sensors and reducing scraps? Do you have any, you know, anecdotal stories or any great feedback from customers so far?
Yeah, actually, I've got a couple of the people I'm working with in automotive industry. They're making high volume parts. It gets back to that pallets of parts being scrapped. They pull parts offline, they start making inspections. Their machines are moving so fast that they're pretty much, if they don't catch an error right away, they are throwing away a pallet full of 10,000 parts versus getting the sensor installed, learning how to program it, figuring out where the data goes. And then again, once they have that data, they can start looking at improving their process in other ways.
And I think it's amazing when we look at Mitutoyo and we look at innovation, really the two go hand in hand. You're looking at top of the line precision, top of the line innovation. I have to ask, will there be more coming out in this new sensor line?
Absolutely. Just started the process of releasing the next model, which is actually an even higher accuracy of 9 microns, a little bit shorter of a measuring range though. And hopefully by the end of this year, I will be releasing the third model, which will actually have a little bit longer of a measuring range, but it'll be 50 microns. Again, though, as I've took a look at some of the competitors' models, we really look like we're still going to be the most accurate in class for both of those. So Mitutoyo is accuracy is our business.
So Mike, the sensors are one component here, but I think we also have to talk about the software, because I think that's where it can tend to get a little tricky. Do you need to buy software to go along with these sensors?
No, you don't. Actually, with our models, the software is included with the sensor. There's no licensing fees. There's no fee to update. There's no additional cost whatsoever for any of the software. If we make any updates to it in the future, those will absolutely be free too. Everything is included and you're ready to go once you get the unit.
Fantastic, Mike. I cannot thank you enough for your time today and your passion and really just being innovative in the market.
Thank you.
It was great hanging out with Mike today. And if you enjoyed the conversation as much as I did, make sure that you go ahead and like and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any upcoming episodes. To find out more about surface measure sensors, visit www.mscdirect.com/products/Mitutoyo-laser scanner. Thanks so much. And we'll see you next time on Tooling Up.
Want more insights and ideas to improve the efficiency and productivity of your operations? Check out the Tooling Up video playlist to hear tips that can take your company to the next level. And subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out.